But anyway, we're going to look at talent today. But I decided I'm going to get up here where you can see. I don't know if y'all notice, every Sunday I come with my shoes dirty. Yeah, I know some of you say, what? You mean a pastor coming in with shoes that got mud on them and all this stuff? Well, every morning, even Sunday morning, I have to feed animals. And right now I got four sheep, and I'm telling you what, they're a mess. Well, they remind me of you guys a lot, okay? Because every Sunday morning, I got to feed you somehow. And sometimes it's a mess and it gets, you know, it sort of splashes over on you, you know. So I come to church with mud on my shoes because I know I have to take care of my sheep. And I just, you know, I just thought about that. This last week, if you notice, I had a bad spot on my pants. I wore some khakis, and it's because one of them jumped up in my lap. And I'm going, Gertie, you've never done that before. Why'd you have to do it before I go to church? But anyway, so anyway, if you see my muddy shoes, you know I'm shepherding sheep and feeding sheep. But anyway, I love you guys. You're my family, and I enjoy coming to church and seeing each one of you and seeing you during the week. And I do want to see us taking a much more energetic approach to inviting people in our homes. You don't have to know them. You can invite them and get to know them. And you know, one of the things when I built my house, and my youngest daughter gave us a little hard time about it the other day, but I built it so that we could invite people over. Because that's part of God's kingdom. And I want to encourage you, and that's not a part of my sermon, but I want to encourage you to look around and invite somebody over. You know what? It doesn't matter if your house is little and it's dirty. I know, ladies in here, I know that's what you're doing. I can't let people come over here. My house is little. You know, he's got a big house. No. The Bible says that God is not a respecter of people, and in particular what they own. But don't let those excuses, it keep you from inviting your brothers and sisters to your home and get breaking bread with them. Take communion. You don't have to do it here at church. You can do it at home with each other. You've got the greatest thing in common, and that's your Savior. You know, you don't have to have it much else. That's enough. Anyway, I'm getting off my sermon here. So let's look at our talents and giftings a little bit. You know, the question I ask you this morning is, what motivates you? Because when we get right down to it, using your talents and giftings has a lot to do with what motivates you. What gets you excited? What are you passionate about? And that's crucial in being able to be a good steward and using those talents and giftings for God's glory. But when God asks me to do something, I'm sometimes I make this personal. When he asked me to do something,